Hi friends, welcome to Sunil Engineering Academy and I am Sunil. First of all, thanks to everyone who subscribed my channel. I know that all the electronic students waiting for RRB JEE CBT2 preparation strategy and best books and some preparation tips. So in this class, I am going to discuss about CBT2 preparation. This class will give you better idea on CBT2. And this video is only for electronic students. Only for electronic students. So remaining students may skip this video. And I don't want to waste time. Let's start the class. We know that the RRB JEE 2019 has two CBTs. That is CBT1 and CBT2. And I have already posted a video on this CBT1 preparation strategy and best books and also preparation tips. So first of all, go and watch the CBT1 strategy and then come for this CBT2. If you have already seen the CBT1 video, then follow this CBT2 strategy. Okay. And we know that CBT1 exam is only qualifying nature. CBT1 exam is only qualifying nature. That means the weightage of CBT1 is not considered for final selection, and the CBT1 is only appear for CBT2 exam. So the final selection is based on only this CBT2 exam. So CBT2 is most important. Okay, coming to the CBT2 pattern for electronics engineering. Total 5 sections. First one, general awareness. It has 15 questions with 15 marks. Second one, physics and chemistry. 15 questions, 15 marks. Computer awareness, 10 questions, 10 marks. And the fourth one, environmental and pollution control. 10 questions, 10 marks. This is a new subject. And next, fifth one, technical abilities. That is 10 questions, 10 marks. Total 150 questions, 150 marks, and the time given for this CBT2 is 120 minutes, that is 2 hours. That means for 150 questions, we have 120 minutes. That means for one question, we have less than 1 minute only. That means here the time management is very, very important for CBT2 exam. Okay, and coming to the each and every section, first of all, coming to the technical abilities, it has 100 marks weightage. So it is very, very important for CBT2. This time, the technical ability section is different for each branch. That is, for example, the electronics students need to study only the electronic subjects. Okay, no need to study other branch subjects. And here, the important thing is, RRB JEE is a diploma level job. It is a diploma level job. So the question paper is in diploma standard only. So you need to study all the basics of subjects. Don't expect difficult questions and difficult problems like GATE. It is too different from GATE. Okay. Remember this thing. Okay. And coming to the subjects under this technical abilities for electronics engineering. First one, electronic components and materials. Electronic components and materials. The coming to this, the subtopics are conductors, semiconductors, insulators, and some magnetic materials and electronic components like switch gear, relays, and MCBs. I think those are electrical components, but it has given under electronic components. Okay. And coming to the electronic devices and circuits, it is very, very important for RRB JEE exam. It has diodes, transistors, oscillators, amplifiers, rectifiers, inverters, multivibrators. Those topics comes under this section. Coming to the next subject, digital electronics. That is number systems, gates, and sequential and combination circuits and converters, A to D, D to A converters like. Okay. And coming to the linear ICs, it has the total syllabus of op-amps. And next one, coming to microprocessors and microcontrollers. Microprocessor is based on 8085. Okay. And next one, electronic measurements. Electronic measurements, that is different measuring instruments and their extension ranges, CRO and LVD, LCD and transducers are coming under this electronic measurement subject. And communication and data communication, it is analog and digital communications. And coming to the next one, computer programming, C, C++ and some data structures, DBMS, comes under this computer programming. 10th one, basic electrical engineering. In this, DC analysis, AC analysis and magnetic circuits, those topics comes under this basic electrical engineering. Okay. Coming to the expected weightage of subjects, first one, electronic components and materials. From this subject, we may expect 7 to 8 marks, nearly 7 to 8 marks. And coming to the second subject, that is very, very important one, electronic devices and circuits, that is EDC. This is very, very important for RRBJE. From this subject, we may expect nearly 20 questions, that is 20 marks. Okay. And coming to the digital, we may expect nearly 10 marks. And coming to the linear ICs, we may expect 6 to 7. And coming to the microprocessor and microcontrollers, from this also we may expect 6 to 7. And coming to electronic measurements, from this we may expect 7 to 8. And coming to the communication, we may expect nearly 25 questions from this analog and data communication. And coming to the computer program, we may expect 7 to 8 questions. And for basic electrical engineering, that is nearly 10 marks. Okay. So here the EDC one is most important for RRBJE exam. Okay. Coming to the preparation tips, if you are going to prepare any competitive exams, keep in mind that knowledge in syllabus is most important. Knowledge in syllabus is most important. So you have to take printout of total syllabus. First step or first tip is you have to take printout of total syllabus and you have to read it 2 to 3 times at least. Then you will get clear idea on the total syllabus, which you feel easy subjects, which you feel difficult subjects or which are unknown. Okay. And the next one, always start the preparation with subjects which you feel very easy, then you will get more confidence on this exam. For example, if you start the preparation with a difficult subject or difficult topic, you feel like, oh no, this exam is very difficult, I think I may not clear this, then automatically you lose your confidence. It will impact on your preparation. So always start with easy subjects, then you will get more confidence and surely you will crack the exam. So second one is start the any one subject which you feel very easy and prepare all the basics of that subject and then only you have to go for another subject. Okay. And the third important one is make notes. Making the notes is very, very important. This will be useful for quick revision. Okay. So make notes on important formula. And the next one, practice. Practice makes man perfect. You know that. Okay. So practice number of beats with respect to the previous diploma level job questions. Okay. So practice more number of beats is very, very important. And next one, always stick on the topics which you have already completed. Then you will get clear idea on your preparation. Most important thing is don't think heavily about competition and vacancies, because you want only one post, not all. Okay. So don't think on competition heavily. If you have full of confidence with smart preparation and practice, you can easily crack any competitive exam. Okay. Coming to the best books for CBT 2 Electronics Engineering, as per RRB JEE 2019, 100% technical syllabus not covered by any single book available in the market. But some of the objective books covers nearly 75 to 80% of the syllabus. I will give idea on the objective books for your preparation. For any electronics engineering competitive exams, all of you know the very important book is R.K. Rajput. R.K. Rajput. If you ask any job holders who are working in government sector, like which book you have prepared, which is the best one, they simply give the answer one and only R.K. Rajput. Coming to this book, it contains number of theoretical bits. So it is useful for both diploma level and also B.Tech level jobs. Okay. So electronic students must have this book for practice. Okay. But one disadvantage of this book is it has only the answer key but no explanation. Okay. And coming to the second one, that is Electronics and Communication Engineering by J.B. Gupta. It is also one of the objective book for electronics engineering. The author J.B. Gupta is famous for electrical engineering. Okay. But coming to this electronics, this book has number of practice bits. Okay. And the concepts are also very good. If you have already the book R.K. Rajput, and after complete of this Rajput, you can also try this J.B. Gupta, or otherwise leave it. Okay. And coming to the next one, the third one, that is Previous IES Bits by Made Easy Publications. It is very, very, very useful for any competitive exams. If you want to prepare Previous IES Bits, then go for it, because it has good explanation. Okay. And coming to the individual books, for circuit theory, William Heath or Van Valkenburg. For integrated electronics, Jacob Millman. For linear ICs, Ramakant. And for measurements, that is A.K. Sahani. And EDC, electronic devices and circuits, Jacob Millman. And for communication, both analog and digital, by Sanjay Sharma. These books are very, very useful for IES, GATE or any PSU exams. These are the best individual books. Okay. For RRB JEE, no need to buy all these books. If you also preparing for B.Tech level jobs or IES or GATE, then only go for these books. Okay. I have posted the links of all these books in my description box and comments. If you don't have and want to buy any book, go and buy from those links. Okay. Coming to the next section, General Awareness, Physics and Chemistry. These are also in CBT1, and I have already discussed in CBT1 strategy. And once again, for current affairs, you have to follow Bankers Adda monthly capsules or grade up last 6 months. For GK, Lucent GK is the best one. Okay. And for physics and chemistry, Lucent General Science is the best one. And you can also download the NCERT 6th to 10th books. These are also useful. And also follow our channel video classes. And practice previous bits. Next section, computer awareness. For this, Arihant and Lucent. These are the very important books for computer awareness. Arihant is the best one, I think, because it has better concepts and also previous bits. So that's why Arihant is the recommended book. And coming to the basics of environment and pollution, at present, no specific book available. So wait for this section. Okay. And finally, the best scores for each section. First one, general awareness. 10 out of 15 is the best score. And coming to physics and chemistry, you can try for 10 to 12 marks out of 15. Coming to the computers, you can get 10 to 10. Coming to the environment, no idea on this subject. Coming to the next, technical. For technical, nearly 80 to 85 is the best score. Okay, it is the top score. You can try for 80 marks. Okay, friends, please subscribe my channel and all the best. Thank you very much. Okay.